to IPM Leap. In today's video, we are going to discuss the topic of number of diagonals in a polygon of n sides. Now, what's a polygon? A polygon is a plane figure having minimum three straight sides and angles. In most cases, a polygon will also have a special name depending on the number of its sides. For example, a polygon with three sides is called a triangle. A polygon with four sides is called a quadrilateral. A polygon with five sides is called a pentagon. A polygon with six sides is called a hexagon, and so on. Counting the number of diagonals in a polygon is a popular question asked in all entrance exams. This question is a cakewalk if you know the formula for the number of diagonals. The number of diagonals in a polygon of n sides is equal to n into n minus 3 divided by 2. But many students find it difficult to understand where this formula came from, which in turn makes it difficult for them to memorize it. In this video, I am going to give you techniques to derive this formula within seconds, which will also help you learn and apply it to related questions. So let's begin. To derive the formula for the number of diagonals, let's take a decagon, a polygon with 10 sides. Now, first things first, a polygon of n sides will have how many vertices? It will have exactly n vertices. To draw a diagonal, each vertex can be joined with other n minus 3 vertices. That is, all others except itself and the adjacent two. So, there will be exactly n minus 3 diagonals originating from any vertex. Let me illustrate this for the decagon on your screen. A decagon has 10 sides and 10 vertices. So let's suppose I select vertex A, the green dot, and try to join it to other vertices to form diagonals. So I will be able to join it to all other vertices in this decagon except itself and the adjacent two vertices shown by green dots. Out of 10 vertices, 10 minus 3, that is 7, can be joined with our selected vertex A, and that forms 7 diagonals. Similarly, it's easy to see that there will be 7 diagonals originating from each vertex. So let's take a count of these diagonals. 7 diagonals per vertex and 10 vertices in all. That makes 7 into 10, that is 70 diagonals. But there is a catch here. Each diagonal gets counted twice in this scheme. For instance, if I take the diagonal AG, this diagonal gets counted when we were counting the diagonals originating from A, and will get counted again when we are counting the diagonals originating from vertex G. So all we need to do is divide this count 70 by 2 to get our actual number of diagonals. Therefore, a decagon will have 70 divided by 2, that is 35 diagonals. Let's extend this concept for a polygon of n sides. The number of diagonals in a polygon of n sides will be n into n minus 3 divided by 2. Now, I am going to give you an alternate and much easier derivation of the same formula. It goes like this. Whenever we select any two vertices out of n, we get either a diagonal or a side of the polygon, isn't it? So, number of diagonals is simply equal to the number of ways of selecting two vertices out of n minus the number of sides. Number of diagonals is equal to nc2, which is the number of ways of selecting two vertices out of n, minus n, the number of sides. Once you master the concept of combinations, you will know that this formula for the number of diagonals simplifies to n into n minus 3 divided by 2. Finally, let's practice two questions on this concept. The first is, how many diagonals does a convex polygon with 11 sides have? So n is equal to 11 here. Number of diagonals is equal to n into n minus 3 divided by 2. So if n is 11, we get 11 into 11 minus 3 divided by 2. That is 11 into 4. 44 diagonals. So a polygon of 11 sides has 44 diagonals. The next question is, if a polygon has 65 diagonals, how many sides are there in the polygon? So number of diagonals in terms of sides is n into n minus 3 divided by 2. That is given. And we have assumed that the polygon has n sides, right? So number of diagonals is equal to 65. Multiply this equation with 2 on both sides. We get n into n minus 3 is equal to 130. Now, even though this equation is a quadratic equation, we can solve it by trial and error. Because don't forget, n is a natural number. It stands for the number of diagonals, right? So try writing the right-hand side as a product of two factors of 130, which are close and differ only by 3. Because left-hand side, we can see that n and n minus 3 differ by 3, right? So we know 130 can be written as 13 into 10. And therefore, comparing both sides of the equation, n is equal to 13. Hope you enjoyed this maths lesson. Don't forget to press the like button if you did. And also press the bell icon next to subscribe to get notifications about other such useful content on our channel. PDF of this lesson is available for free on our website www.ipmlib.com. Happy learning!